All right, now. He gets into Chicago out of, from where are you coming from? Portland, Oregon. That's where the police record stated him. They have him registered as that being his place of birth. All right? He was of American birth, an American citizen, and he was born in the year 1891 AD. Although they list him as 1877. Just look at the picture on the wall behind the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and calculate the date from 1877 to 1930, 1931, all the way to 1930, and see if that man is that age. Wallace Dodd Ford was born 1891 AD, and he, with the help of the FBI, assumed the name of the original, or the personality and birth certificate of the original one who they eliminated. They needed him to infiltrate the organization amongst those who didn't know him. He was born in Portland, Oregon. Nationality, white American. Color eyes, brown. Color hair, brown. What was his blood type even? He had type A, they call that an anti-B antibody, right? That is the blood of a Caucasian, not that of a Nubian. What was his religion? By birth, he was a Mormon by birth. Affiliation, Nazism, FBI, and a double agent. Now this is the Caucasian one, the one that's being circulated as the real one. What was his mother's name? Minnie Z. Ford. Where was she from? She was a British living in Polynesia. What was her maiden name? Dejon. What was his father's name? Alfonso Dodd Ford. What was he? A merchant seaman of British birth. Did I do my homework? He himself married and had a wife named Hazel Burton. They had a son, his name was Wallace Max Ford. He was born September 10th, 1938 in Los Angeles, California. These are things Sheikh Daoud got on record. He brought out the Crusader and all the investigation papers, the police records, the files, the blood type. He did this stuff. He was giving it to me and I didn't want it. I was not interested in it, but it was given to me anyway. I don't want to be the one that makes all this stuff clear. It's not my business. But they made it my business. I said in 1990, I'd give up. Let me go about my business. But no. They got to wake up the sleeping lion and start the name calling. So now you want the rest of the information? I'm going to give you what I was given. You have a right not to believe in my, what I refer to as mentor, Sheikh Daoud, and I have a right not to believe in your interpretation. But mine is backed up with facts, and yours is not producing any facts. Because you can't tell us where your father went, when he was born, where he was born, his mother and father. All you guys are bunk of mythology. I get you a date, facts, blood type, and even have his fingerprint on record. This can be gotten, you can assess this. But you don't want to hear it. I understand. That's what blind faith is about. All right? So now, once he relocated, he left Portland, Oregon around 1914 at age 23. And he started to reside in California. He started getting arrested there. He was a troublemaker. By 1918 through 1926, he had three different arrests from age 27 to 38. Sentenced eventually to life and made a deal with the government. This deal got him his release in 1929 at age 38, about the age of the picture on the wall, when he was to assume the personality of the devil. Did the Honorable Elijah Muhammad know the original? No. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad was affiliated with the Ahmadiyya group. He had an Ahmadiyya name, Ghulam Abulam. Everybody knew that. They know he wore an Ahmadiyya cap. They knew he was involved with the Moorish Science Temple. His followers deny it, but they know he wears a Moorish Science cap. He used the Yusuf Ali Quran first, and he shows him holding picture of the Yusuf Ali Quran, which is a Sunni Quran, and then he switches over to the Ahmadiyya Quran, which is the Quran that Minister Louis Farrakhan and I use today. There's some affiliation there, which we'll get into. If y'all want me to go on, then I can go home. You want to hear the rest? You want to hear? All right, so I'll do my best. Okay, here. Now, so he first pops up in Chicago at the Moorish Science Temple, claiming to be the reincarnation of Noble Drew Ali. Right, this is in July 4th, 1930. Now he's about 39 years old. He disappears around June 30th, around 1934, at age 43. This is when they say he left. Why did he leave? We'll get into that. You see, on August 15, 1959, a newspaper article appeared in Chicago News called The Crusader. The headline listed Master W.D. Fard Muhammad as another of Wallace Dodd's false aliases. All right? As a Turkish ex-agent of Adolf Hitler, Nazi, this paper was repeated. The article was put out again around August 1st, 1959. Who do you think was behind these articles? Sheikh Daoud. Who was Sheikh Daoud? A Moroccan Fez-born Nubian who influenced the Moorish Science Temple. I know. I was with him since 1957. Don't say Imam Isa took a Shahada on the Lucrin and Space Street. You lie. And you know you lie. And I got documents to prove it. But you don't want to see the documents because you'd like to shut my mouth because you don't want to know the truth because if the truth will make you free enough to come join the ACS. All right. Now, who wrote that, they say? It was written by none other than my mentor, Haji Talib Daoud. That was Sheikh Daoud's real name. Many people don't know that. He later changed his name to Sheikh Daoud. He was born, check the date, in 1891, and he died in 1980. And I was there. And his brothers, if they're honest, will come forward and tell you. We was in stage three, we was at the hospital with him. And he pointed and said, you're the man to take over. And he gave me all his manuscripts and said, you do this here. I don't want him to do it. This wasn't my business. I was not concerned with a man that was that had left in 1934 here. I'm 1970, worrying about after coming out of a 1960 revolution, what to do with my people. All right, now let's check out, as you know him, whose real name was what? Haji Talib Daoud, that's right. All right, he known later as Sheikh Daoud, everybody knows. Now, when was he born? 1891. He founded what was referred to as the Islamic Mission in America. He was an avid enemy of the man who was the imposter. He knew he was pretending because he was very close to Fawad Abdul Ali Muhammad. Why? Because both of them were funded by the same family, the Saud family from Saudi Arabia. He knew him. He's the one who suggested he change his name to Abdul Wali Farah Muhammad so that he could stay the heck out of trouble. Sheikh Daoud tried to help this guy, but this guy was just an angry, vicious Arab who kept getting himself in trouble until he finally got himself killed. All right? Want me to go on at this point? All right, because I'm getting out of wind here. At the time, Sheikh Daoud owned two businesses. He had his own enterprises, one in Harlem and one in Philadelphia. Right now, in the year 1950, at age 59, he used his own money, because he had used, remember, Saudi Arabia was funding him, and he brought out that same paper called the Crusader. Don't believe me? Go check it out. Right? He ordered them same articles to be reprinted about Wallace Darfur, who they sometimes refer to as Wali, W-A-L-I. He had a whole list of names when he got arrested. All right? Now, when he put that article out, he knew this was going to cause a lot of problems. He knew this was going to cause a lot of people in America to be mad at him. But Sheikh Daoud, if you knew him the way I knew him, he didn't care. He was concerned with the truth. What are we concerned with? The truth. Our brothers and sisters that are being led by the wrong people, they don't want us to stop and correct them. While I see people gathering around thinking someone's teaching the truth and they're not telling the whole story, they'll go from Savior's Day to Savior's Day, and it's supposed to be a representation of Farah's Day, and never do you give a full history. You have a mythological history about an original black man who's alike, having a white woman with seven demons in her, which is confined, like I said before, right in the book of Luke, and cast the demons out and give birth to God, and God had disguised himself. He was an unalike. He didn't look like us. God had disguised himself so that nobody don't beat him up, then he can't help me. How can he help me? He disguised himself. He can come ask who he is. I'm standing here. I'm a God of flesh. I'm asked who I am. I've been teaching in 1970 and have withstand all of their threats. I've been abused by birds, but they won't come out against me to deal with the truth. Because they know I'm right. They know I'm exact at all times. All right, now, a few years later, an article pops up in Los Angeles, California, the Herald Examiner. That's on July 29, 1969, claiming that black Muslim founder is exposed as white. Now, why would Elijah Muhammad take the posture of denying the man in the article that was W.D. Farr, as the article implied? Muhammad Speaks wrote a rebuttal to the article. It was released in Los Angeles, California, at the Herald Examiner, on July 29, 1963. And August 16, 1963, we released it, right? They answered the claim that the Nation of Islam offered $100,000, right, to clear up the charge if anyone can prove that that man, which is the picture behind the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, is that Nazi or that white man, that Caucasian, who is a phony. Now, until this time, Sheikh Daoud didn't have nothing to say about it. He stopped because it was a fruitless battle. Now, Sheikh had all the investigators, all these people with him. He retrieved the arrest records on fraud. He got all the information. And he even got the arrest record of June 12, 1926, which had the mug shots. That was on the docket, I think it was C-1179924. You can go look it up, the Bureau of Criminal Investigation. After doing an overlay, which is called morphing today, a technique that's used with computers enhancements, and overlaying each picture, I did this myself. I said, whoa, wait a minute. All of these faces are the same people. We start laying faces over faces and the lips and the eyes line up. Something is wrong. These are all the same man. And I begin to wonder, why is the Nation of Islam denying the man that was supposed to be their savior? Because they did not know that he was the imposter. They thought that he was the real one. They were fooled. And it can happen to anybody.